Today we're going to use an oscilloscope to look at the three different effects that capacitance can have on electrical systems. Hi, welcome to the 2-Minute Guru. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff. Earlier in this season, we've been looking pretty much at DC systems. We've looked at resistance, voltage, and current. Now it's time to look at AC systems, and today we're going to look at capacitance. We're going to look at the three effects that capacitors have on your system using an actual capacitor, but capacitance is actually present in pretty much every electrical system, so understanding what those three effects are will help you analyze and diagnose your circuits later on. Our circuit setup today is super simple. We have the wavegen from my oscilloscope running through a resistor, and that's probed with channel one, and then we're going to put a capacitor in parallel with that resistor to see what happens. The first effect that capacitance has on a system is it's going to resist a change in voltage and store charge, according to the formula Q equals C times V. So let's add the capacitor and compare before and after. I'm gonna save this waveform using a reference waveform. So I hit the reference waveform, save, save to R1, and then I'm gonna display it on screen. So when I turn off channel one, you can actually see that waveform there. Now let's turn channel one back on and add the capacitor. And you can see if I zoom in here, this region, my capacitor is charging up. It's resisting that step up in voltage. Here, my capacitor is starting to discharge. So all of that charge stored up when the voltage was high is slowly trickling out of my capacitor after my source voltage has already gone low. So if you see your system resisting voltage changes or adding some charge back in after the voltage has turned off, you know that's a capacitive effect. And this effect is roughly how switch mode power supplies operate. When the power is supplied to the capacitor, it begins to charge up, and then when it's turned off, the capacitor discharges that energy into the system. And that leads us to the second effect of capacitance, frequency filtering. There's two different ways to look at this. First, let's look at our signal from before. Remember that a square wave is made up of an infinite number of increasing frequency sine waves. When I remove the capacitor, we get a nice crisp edge, but when I add the capacitor, we see that that edge gets a little rounder, and that's because the capacitor is filtering out the higher frequency components that make up that nice square wave. Another way to look at this is with a pure sine wave. At lower frequencies, the capacitor is going to absorb those frequencies. It's gonna charge up the capacitor and discharge the capacitor as the signal goes up and down. But if I crank up the frequency, we're gonna see a smaller amplitude of that signal on the capacitor, which means those frequencies are passing right through the capacitor. So it's filtering out the low frequencies and letting the high frequencies pass through it. The ability of capacitance to filter out frequencies is widely used in electrical engineering. A couple examples would be getting a cleaner power rail, you can filter out some of the ripple on that, or separating frequencies out for audio applications. The third effect of capacitance is that it can change the phase relationship between voltage and current. So I've hooked up a current probe to channel two and I put the scope in averaging mode like I like to do with this current probe. And you can see right now my voltage and current are in phase. They're both rising and falling at the same point in time. But let's see what happens if I add a capacitor. You can see that as soon as I add the capacitor, the current shifted forwards in time. So the current is now leading the voltage, or the voltage is lagging the current thanks to that capacitor. And we can use the oscilloscope to measure that. So I'm gonna hit measure and I'm gonna add a phase measurement. It's all the way at the bottom. And we can see that I'm getting about a 45 degree phase shift, and that's because my capacitor is in parallel with my resistor. If I pull my resistor out, I should get to see about a 90 degree phase shift from my capacitance. And we do see a roughly 90 degree phase shift between voltage and current when I have just a capacitor. And the ability to control the phase relationship between voltage and current is really useful, especially in power, where you're concerned about instantaneous power, which is current times voltage. You can actually use capacitance to adjust your phase to get the maximum power out of your systems. So those are the three effects of capacitance that you can put into your engineering toolbox: storing charge, filtering frequency, and changing the phase between voltage and current. And that's all we have time for today. Thanks for watching. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff. Make sure you subscribe to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel and check out our free ebook download, 6 essential tips for getting the most out of your oscilloscope. I'll see you next time.